So, a feller in town recognized me from Blackwater.
That's not good.
It's okay, though. I dealt with it.
Oh, hi, Arthur.
Here.
If there's nothing you need, will you get out of here? What is it, Arthur? Yes, Arthur?
My lady?
Hi.
You seem miles away.
I'm fine.
What are you doing back here?
Don't mind me, Dutch.
What is it, Arthur?
What do you want?
Uncle told me something about a train.
What did he say?
Mary Beth overheard something about a train full of wealthy folk rolling down through Scarlet Meadows just south of the state border?
Yes.
Need help with it?
I ain't even sure about doing it.
Come on. At night, not too guarded, it's perfect.
Nah, I ain't thought it through. You know, stopping a train, pain in the ass.
Sure, but what if we could force a train to stop?
Well, of course.
We get a wagon full of something flammable, oil. Put it on the tracks. They see it. They know they either have to stop or die. Ain't no train driver wants to be cooked alive.
That is kind of brilliant. For you. That is a real idea. I think that's the first time you ever had one of them.
Shut up.
You might be the first bastard to ever have half his brains eaten by a wolf and end up more intelligent.
So we're doing it?
Yeah, we're gonna need ammunition, guns, look real frightening, and some dynamite to open up the train.
I'll get the supplies. Gotta head into town for Abigail anyway. Don't even ask. You go find us an oil wagon.
Yeah, I know just the place. They're always heading into that refinery.
There's an old rundown shack just over the border, north of a place called Dewberry Creek. Leave it hidden somewhere near there.
Arthur.
All right. Okay, girl.
Your horse?
Sounds good.
Shit. Okay, then. Thank you.
Shit! Son of a bitch! even allowed around
here? Hey, you there.
It's all private good. Property. Calm down.
Move along now.
Be on your
you ain't supposed to be around
here. Sorry. I'll stop messing with you now. All right, simmer down. Can't treat people with respect. What's the point, I say?
Come on, work!
Get.
What lovely weather.
God's own country, this is.
Got a good hole there, girl.
Let's go, girl.
It's you. Hello, mister.
Thank you.
I recognize that face. Go on, have yourself a quick nosy. After a little tchotchke, are we?
Thank you, girl. Each to their own, my friend.
Clear out of here, please.
Costing you a pretty penny to repay your debt.
Just to be honest, it was all a big misunderstanding.
Have yourself a nice trip.
Hello, mister.
Oh, hello.
Hello, ma'am.
How do you do?
Oh, what in tarnation you think you're doing here?
Howdy.
Right here, folks.
Howdy there.
Too damn close to me. You got a problem you want me to solve?
Excuse me.
You're lucky I'm in a good mood.
You look like a man on a mission.
there, and welcome. Quite the bounty you acquired, ain't it? See you later.
Swords here. I took a little jolt and have managed to get myself hopelessly lost. I am staying in Strawberry. If you could just guide me back.
Can't think of a good reason to say no.
Oh, thank you, sir. Shall I hop up there on the back with you?
Your legs work, don't they?
Well, yes, I suppose. It's just a little demeaning.
What are you doing out here, anyway? This clearly ain't your natural habitat.
I'm just visiting. I'm from New York City, actually.
You don't say.
Oh, yes. There was some talk at the country club about this burgeoning little resort town called Strawberry. So I thought it might be quite the trip to see what all the fuss was. Perhaps make a few investments while it was still undervalued. Turns out I was made the fool.
Not enjoying it, then?
It's a town of splinters. If you could call it much of a town at all, I'd hardly stepped off the carriage and I'd taken in the whole place. I suppose some might call it charming. Tell you, charm is not worth much these days. You show me a timber frame shack and I'll show you Broadway. And meanwhile, you have this mayor, quite intolerable blowhard. A little bespoke woodwork and he thinks this is a cultural hub? The man's completely deluded. Well, I should give him some credit. He must be quite the salesman. He did get me out here after all, more fool me. Now I'm tromping through the leaves in the muck with some cowboy. No offense.
Little taken.
Oh, I remember that! We're on the path!
Wait up, wait up! This isn't a race?
Carry himself.
Will you slow down?
Hey, mister.
How are you, mister?
Oh, are we close to town? Sir, you've rescued me from the depths. You seem quite the resourceful sort, sir. If for some reason you plan to spend any time in Strawberry, you may want to look into that gabbing mayor. Something is definitely off with him.
All right. I'll keep that in mind.
Hello.
Uh-oh.
Arthur. Good to see you.
Why? You want rescuing again, dear?
No. I got a plan to make it up to you.
Oh, a plan like the Blackwater Ferry job, or like you going off scouting and ending up in jail?
Dutch said you was a big shadow cast by a tiny tree.
I don't even know what that means.
I thought you was a tough boy. Not one of those gentlemen trying to protect his riding clothes.
Well, I just know whenever things get real, you turn yellow and lose your head.
Yellow?
Sure seems that way.
So I guess you won't be riding with me to rob the banking coach comes about this time in the Strawberry. I heard one of the O'Driscoll boys yapping about it while I was inside.
You and me? Do a robbery?
That's what I said, didn't I?
After you.
There's a spot up this way with a good view of the trail.
Okay, girl. What are you doing anyway, camping out here like some crazy hermit?
Can't exactly stay in town now, can I? Like I told you, I ain't going back to Dutch without a peace offering.
So what's the deal with this coach?
What do you mean? Comes through about this time every day, like I said, the end.
I mean, how many men, guns, riders?
Nothing serious. It'll be fine.
I heard the bank's been hiring every trigger man they can get of late. The meaner, the better.
You worry too much.
Forgive me if I ain't wholly faithful in something an O'Driscoll told you when you was half drunk in a jail cell.
He kept yapping about it, saying how they've been hitting it on the regular. That's a good lead in my book.
Damn, O'Driscolls are everywhere now.
Bastards got a hold of most of Big Valley. Heard they took over some big ranch north of here.
How the hell you and Lenny end up down here anyway?
Oh, you know how it is? A few loose ends. Drink here, drink there.
What loose ends?
Nothing that needs to concern you. Pay my share.
It concerns me when you put us in danger and we don't realize till it's too late. Like that move you pulled at Strawberry, making me kill half the town just for your precious guns.
Precious they are. You need to roll a little looser, Morgan.
Looser? I seen you come full undone more than once now, and you only been running with us a few months.
Are we gonna rob this coach or bicker about it? What's done is done.
Guess we're robbing it.
Then let's do it. Watch out. All right, this is the spot. Hold up on this ridge.
Whoa!
They should be here in a little bit. Hold tight.
Which way will they be coming in?
Should be from over there. We need to hit them fast before they get into town.
Just don't lose your head this time.
Of course, tough guy. They should be here any minute. Look, there they are. Right on time. Get covered up. Come on! Ride! Yeah!
Guns up, we got trouble.
what in the hell guns up we got?
Covered now. It's just you and me, sweetheart. Are you getting on? How long does it take? Next time I'll leave you in the dust.
I'm hoping there won't be a next time.
You don't mean... Yeah! Baylock! Come on, boy! Look here. Fine new rifle, too. Here you go, Arthur. From me to you. That's more your style than mine. What did I tell you? Like licking butter off a knife.
Something like that. You don't want to just break it open here, be done with it?
Could be more than we can carry. And there might be... A second crew of riders tailing.
All right, then.
Not to mention, we ride back in with a big take, a new wagon to boot. Judge can't say we ain't pulling our weight no more, can he?
I ain't sure I trust this new act of yours one bit.
Listen, I know we got off on the wrong foot, but I got no beef with you. I reckon we're a lot alike, you and me.
Now, hold up there.
Dutch knows I'm a feller that gets things done, same as you.
Gets things done? You'd be wearing a California collar now if I hadn't broken you out of jail.
And I have expressed my gratitude, have I not? It's done. Main thing now is getting this haul back in one piece.
Shit! Now we're being robbed! Get across the river!
What the hell?
Come on, Arthur, get out of there! You dumb bastards!
Damn! You okay?
I think so. Just take your head down. Let's finish.
That goddamn O'Driscoll!
I can see it!
Thank you.
Job I do with you ends in a pile of dead bodies.
Since when did you have a problem killing O'Driscolls?
You've got a point.
Let's strip this coast then. It clearly ain't going nowhere now. You know, we should really pick up a lockbreaker one of these days. Save ourselves some bullets.
Yeah, because saving bullets is such a concern of yours.
That lock should shoot off easy enough. I'll give you the honors. On account of, well, this little mess.
Go on, then.
That should do it.
Come on, let's see if all this was worth
it. All I see is you, me, a river full of dead O'Driscolls. And a lockbox. I'd say we're golden here, Morgan. Look at that. What's the cut here?
It's good. Just make sure the gang gets its piece.
Yeah, yeah. Like I said, big shadow, tiny tree.
And like I said, that still don't mean nothing. Get out of here. Go see Dutch. Make sure you ain't followed.
I know, boss. I know. It's been fun!
Whoa. Hey, partner. You should keep an eye on that wagon. Giddy up.
there, girl.
Morning, Arthur.
Morning, Mr. Morgan.
Pearson.
Don't make me angry. Don't forget to go hunting, Mr. Morgan.
I will.
Well, the quality's a bit lacking. We won't get much for it.
Thank you, Arthur.
I'm watching you.
Whatever you say.
Delightful, Uncle.
Well, he's cracked in the head, that one.
You busy?
Not too busy. Why?
I heard about a house. Could be interesting.
What kind of a house?
I don't know. A couple fellas I heard in town, they said it was really freakish. A family local boogeyman, I guess. But they're crooked in every way.
So?
Well, so these boys thought they were sitting on a lot of cash. They're highway robbers, kidnappers, apparently. They're well hidden in the woods.
Well, sounds pretty dubious.
Of course. Yeah, it's dubious, but there ain't much risk of getting caught.
Okay, then. Let's go take a look.
Exactly. Just take a look.
Sure, or less. It's okay, girl.
Ha!
Pretty close now. Let's stop and go on foot from here. Just up the hill this way. Follow me.
The
apparently, his family's been isolated for so long, they started talking in their own way. Dialect. They really don't like outsiders, especially on their turf.
Well, you just keep selling me on this job, don't you?
Now, big place, right? You got your binoculars?
Well, there's a pretty big barn in the back. It's not a bad place to start looking. There must be a lot of people living here. A large house.
There could be in any one of them buildings, and who knows how many people are in there.
I ain't sure about this.
Well, I think we need to draw them out somehow. And I got an idea. Follow me.
All these trees. I can't get a proper look at the place.
Well, hopefully it'll make it harder for them to spot us, too.
Coast seems clear so far.
Yeah, so far.
Hey, keep it down. I hear voices. Come on, let's hide behind this shed. See if we can hear what they're saying.
Maybe you want to pick this type of mouth. Wait for a spin. Don't score notes into the dizzy flimmy can.
Just stay quiet.
Where you been now, Newt? Don't be boiling now, Pappy. I's gone but 10 minutes I was.
How can Hollygag order now? Because Edie takes patrol now, don't you?
What? No, Edie, get all the jam!
You shut your gupper, or I'll flagger your felt, I will. You need to pull it up, boy. Up. Go guard the shed.
Go!
You understand what they're saying?
Not much of it. What are we doing, Javier?
Okay, you take cover by the rock over there. I'll create a little distraction, and then you jump them, okay?
What kind of distraction?
You'll see.
Thank you.
Quick, let's look for the stash.
They weren't shy about defending that barn. Let's check in there first.
Has to be under here. There's no place else I could store it. Hey, Arthur, give me a hand here. It was worth the trouble, didn't I?
Yeah. You take this. Let's split up. I'll meet you back at camp.
Sounds good.